WDSU First Warning Weather. I'm calculated about an hour and 15 minutes for landfall officially coming from Hurricane Milton at this time. It's going to be the center of the hurricane, the center of that eye wall that's going to be as it moves on shore, making official landfall. But this storm is already still a major hurricane with max sustained winds at 120. This means gusts are still higher than that. That's just an average wind speed over 1 minute. We've got a northeast movement at 15, and we've got the pressure that's gone up to 952, so we've continued to weaken this storm. The winds have continued to blow this storm apart, as you can see that this is kind of more of a comma-shaped storm at the time. South, really, they're mostly done with at least the worst of the winds and the worst of the various heaviest rain. That's going to move north. These outer bands were responsible for tons of tornadoes earlier in the day. Those are the outer bands with at least a dozen or so reported tornadoes. Doesn't mean there was a dozen tornadoes or two dozen, but at least the number of reports. Still tropical storm status with winds at 70 miles per hour that you can start to see here. As we move in and show you more about what's going on, focused into what's happening in Florida, here is Doppler radar at that time. This is live Doppler radar and showing that, look at those storms, tons and tons of lightning with those supercells out ahead of the main part of the storm, which you zoom in and show that that eye wall, dead center of it right here, just about 25 miles. That's going to be from around Sarasota to Bradenton near Venice here as well. So there's the latest imagery. Still have some lightning strikes out ahead of it too. What are we looking at for wind speeds? 94, 87 miles per hour. I've seen some of the winds as high as 125. And again, that's pretty high up in the sky here too. Rainfall rates coming down again, 1.5, 3.5 inches per hour. That's typical. We could even find rain rates that we had that were upwards of 7 inches per hour. So pretty incredible. Tornado watches have been taken away in some cases. They still remain towards the Florida Keys. They still remain on the east part of the Florida Peninsula from Port St. Lucie to Orlando and still to Tampa and Bradenton. Current wind gusts, 71 miles per hour in Bradenton right here. And we look at the forecast for the strong winds, which we'll still have to deal with the late night and overnight hours. And not until we get to Thursday afternoon will this thing be completely clear from Florida. So there's still a long ways to go. Storm surge just south of Tampa now could top out as high as 13 feet. For Tampa Bay, up to 9 feet, but that's similar to what they had with Hurricane Helene, where they topped out with storm surge. It was around 7 to 8 feet here, too. Rainfall's already estimated closing in near 10 inches of rain, and there is still a lot more of this to come. We could end up with rainfall totals that top out near 17 inches of rain of what we're finding here. We still have flood watches, flood warnings that are still in effect, and we look for the landfall coming in just in about the next hour. That's 6:30 our time, 7:30 their time. So that would be 10 minutes from now, obviously 6:30, so give that another hour. This one's a little bit too quick. Not until we get to Thursday afternoon will the storm be completely gone. So, of course, watching this very closely and sending Florida our best.